Assalamualaikum and a very good evening. Today, I will start my presentation first with the consumer credit. Before that, I will introduce myself. My name is Nurhanisha Hira binti Zul Effendi. And okay, let's begin the presentation now. Okay, did you know what is consumer credit? Okay, consumer credit is a system that allow people to borrow money or take on debt to receive cash, good or services and pay it back in the future. Consumer credit is the use of credit for personal need. Okay, next we move to the type of credit. There are two type of credit, which is first is closed-end credit and next open-end credit. Okay, closed-end credit is a loan agreement in which the lender expect the entirety of the loan including interest and other charges to be paid in full by a stated due date. Okay, next, open and credit allow you to make repeat purchases. You can pay the balance in full each month or make installment payment. Okay, with a credit card, you have a certain amount of credit to use and you are obligated to repay the amount of credit that you have been used. Okay, other than that, the advantages consumer credit is financial flexibility. Okay, in the days before widespread access to credit card, people often had to save for years to make major purchases. Okay, credit allow consumer to spread out major costs over the courses of month or a year, so they do not have to choose when they need to buy something. Okay, in addition, perks and reward also the advantage for consumer credit. Consumers can earn substantial benefit by using credit if they use it wisely. Okay, we've moved on to the disadvantages. Firstly, consumer temptation to overspend means that access to credit make it easier to pay for basic needs and cover emergency expenses. But it also simplify buying expensive product you might want but you don't need it. Okay, next, the disadvantage is interest payment and penalties. The interest rate on consumer credit are often staggeringly high and can force consumer to pay back several times in the initial value of their purchases. Okay, what are the creditor looks for when someone want to make a credit card? Okay, firstly, they see the character, which is they look if you pay bills on time or not. Okay, next is capacity, which is you able or not to pay back for the loan that you already purchased. Other than that, capital, which is creditor will see what asset that you have and also the network. Collateral, and lastly, condition, which is there is an economic problem. Is it affect your ability to pay the loan or not? Okay, that's all for me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Karenisa Binti Kamarudin. Today, I will present about the investment planning. What is investment planning? Investment planning is the act of matching your financial goals and objective towards your financial resources. Investment planning is one of the core components in the financial planning that they cannot live without each other. So there are 7 types of investment, which are the investing in the saving account, investing in fixed deposit, investing in the shares, investing in bonds, investing in the residential home, investing in the residential properties, and the last one is investing in the unit trust. So how do we do the investment planning? There are 6 types of it, which are: first, we set our investment planning, which we set our investment goals, which are what do we want to achieve after we do the investment. And the next one is the risk profiting, which we analyze the risk that would come to us and how to overtake the risk. And the next one is designing the investment portfolio, which we could list all the investment that we could do and we analyze on the benefits that come to it and the disadvantages that will come. And the next one is selecting the specific investment, which the best one that we could do, which investment that really suit to us. And the next one is monitoring the portfolio, which we we'll do the specific investment and we keep on monitoring on the benefit with that come to us. And our last step is rebalancing the portfolio, which we do on improving our investment and do the upgrade by investing in the next investment that we could. And what is the benefits of investment? There are 5 benefits of it, which the having the family security, having the savings, having the efficiently managed income, which we can do our income to a better purposes. Next is having a good standard of living, which we always have our benefits from investing. And the last one is we have a better financial understanding that we plan good on our financial resources. So that's all. With that, I thank you.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. I'm Nur Hidayah binti Nur Azam. I will present to you about retirement planning. Most people think about saving and invest to have significant nest egg to draw upon once they stop working when they retire. But it's not just about that. More than a well fund investment account is required for a secure retirement. Any retirement plan should include the following 5 elements. A steady stream of income will help your nest egg endure much longer, putting off the need to draw into it. Social security benefits, a pension, real estate income, investment profit, part-time work, and other initiatives are all possible sources of retirement income. In most cases, insurance is the best approach to safeguard your assets. Many people have both homeowners and health insurance. You should think about life insurance and long-term care insurance as you approach retirement. Remember to account in potential lost income, how much it will cost to pay off your obligation, and your spouse's life expectancy when estimate your life insurance needs. There are numerous reasons to consider retirement preparation. What crucial tax, saving and investment facts should I plan around? What financial concerns should I address before the year's end? It is better to accept my pension in one single sum. When I retire, how much income can I expect from my portfolio? Retirement planning can assist answer key concerns like this. Money problems are a prominent cause of divorce, which is unsurprising. Maintaining a healthy connection with your spouse can be a compelling reason to start thinking about retirement. If you have to quit your job before your planned retirement age, having a retirement plan in place will put you in a much better position. Saving for medical bill and anticipate long-term care costs is part of a comprehensive retirement strategy. You won't have to rely on your relative to meet the gaps if you know your bills are covered. Now let's take a look at what to watch out for when it comes to retirement planning. Keep in mind the following risks. While no one can tell how long they will live, people over 65 have a good chance of spending 20 years or more in retirement. The longer you live in retirement, the more likely your funds will lose purchasing power and have impact on your lifestyle. Lastly, our withdrawal strategy. The rate at which you draw your saving and investment assets in retirement to cover current living expenditure is crucial in deciding how long your income will last. Being aware of these risks might help you plan ahead and be more financially prepared for retirement. I hope you got something about retirement planning. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Wan Amelia Adira and today I am going to present about estate planning. So, estate planning is a process of making a plan of managing assets of someone who has died based on the requirements that they want and her heirs needs, and while minimizing taxes. So there are potential estate planning problems, which is 5, which is there. Excessive transfer costs, which means when you transfer something, they still need a cost. So 2nd is lack of liquidity, which means assets that are easily turned into money is little. 3rd is improper disposition of assets, which means there's some technical problem and others like that. So short income at retirement, which means retirement when they retire is little. And lastly, short income if disabled. So disabled person needs much more health costs than usual people. So there are 2 areas under estate planning, which is people planning, managing money for the ones you love, and 2nd is asset planning, which is reduce taxes and avoid problems if the ownership is at different places. Next is steps in estate planning process. So we have 7 steps, which is check family situation, gather data, list all assets, appoint assets to the heirs, determine estate transfer costs, apply the plan, and review the plan for the last step. So there are 2 instruments in estate planning instruments, which is a stated estate, which is people who has a will, and second is intestate estates, which is having no will. So it is pretty common for people who doesn't have a will. So most people are intestate estates. When this occurs, summary administration will handle the situation and will divide the ownership and inheritance properly. Lastly, faraid. So the faraid is the law of inheritance in Islam. So there are 3 causes of inheritance under faraid, which is nikah, which means you have a valid marriage contract with the person. It will fall under faraid. So wala is relationship, which means when you have a connection with the person. And lastly is kinship, which means blood related people like your parents, your uncle, aunts, and etc. So if a female died, only 3 inheritors, male inheritors, that can receive the inheritance, which is the son, father, and husband. While if a male die, only 5 female inheritors will inherit the inheritance, which is the daughter, son's daughter, mother, wife, and full sister. And that is all from me, and thank you for listening.
Hello, my name is Nur Al-Mastum with DGPFD. Now I will present our last topic, which is future financial challenge. It is the obstacle that you need to face regarding your financial problem that block you from going as you plan. It can be long-term and short-term depending on what kind of challenge. Okay, I will proceed to future financial challenge. First, money spending exceed income. Many consumers struggle with the basic challenge of having an income that doesn't cover their expenses. This means that the person is exceeding their limit and spend more than what they earn. Next, lack of money and budgeting management skill. For someone who do not know how to do financial planning, it will be hard for them to book better financial planning for the rest of their life. We may get trouble with our finance because we don't have skill to manage our money. Third, no emergency fund. Unfortunate things can happen, such as being fired, involved in a car accident, and unexpected injury. Everyone need to provide an emergency fund for their own benefit. Fourth, don't have enough money for retirement. Everyone want to enjoy their retirement. In order to do that, they need to have enough money. Sometimes, people forget to save a portion for their income for the retirement. Some people don't have retirement planning because they have a lot of debt or overspending their money. Last but not least, paying student loan debt. Student loan will greatly affect the person's financial. The debt will also limit their ability to buy a home. People need to find a way to settle the loan as quick as possible, as there will be more interest need to be paid over time. They also should find another source of income in order to pay the debt, so it will not affect their income. How to overcome? First, create a budget. Check your expenses to build a budget that's work. Prepare a monthly budget and try our best to comply with the budget. Creating a budget should be a basic for all your other financial decisions. It allows us to see where our money is going each month and to set realistic target for control our spending, thus speeding up the process of wealth accumulation. Next, increase your income. We can consider many ways to make some cash. Cutting down our expenses can only work to a reasonable extent without an increase in what we rate in. So we can increase income by doing a part-time job to earn money, to earn more money. Adding new income by start an online business or find another side income will increase our income. Third, saving for emergency. We need to spare part of their income as an emergency fund. This money can help a lot when a rainy day hit. We must try to save some money from monthly salary for at least 10% from the salary, so that we can use that money when emergency occur. Fourth, manage your bill. We must set a date twice a month to review all our accounts so that we don't miss any due date. Schedule electronic payment or mail check so that our payment arrives several days before it do. This way, if a delay occur, our payment will probably still arrive on time. If we are having trouble keeping track of all our accounts, start compiling a list. When our list is complete, we can use it to make sure we are on top of all our accounts and to see if there are any we can combine or close.